as you can.
We let's don't know continue. What's gonna happen. Let's continue this conversation, moving into the next topic. Ray Tanner, who is South Carolina's athletic director, he came out and said that we will not know the plans, or the plans won't be announced for college football until early August. Now, the idea was, from everybody that had anything to do with anything, all the anonymous sources, all that kind of mess, was a decision would have to be made at the beginning of July. You would have to know something at the beginning of July. This is what Ray Tanner said yesterday on the South Carolina Athletics website. At this point, we do not know what the 2020 football season will look like. Our goal is to communicate the plan for the season in early August. We want to be able to gather as much information as possible, working with the SEC office and the member institutions before any decisions are made. These are challenging and, yes, agonizing times. As a coach and administrator, my vow is to provide student-athletes with the resources to compete at the highest level, whether it be in their sport, in the classroom, in the community, or in life. As your AD, I'm taking part in regular meetings with President Castlin and campus planning groups, as well as Commissioner Sankey and the Southeastern Conference ADs. These groups have the health and safety of our student-athletes, coaches, staff, and fans are the most important pieces of the puzzle. We all want you to get the best and most accurate information as soon as we can as we move forward with challenging and difficult decisions. I will never give up pursuing what our program needs to adequately represent the student-athletes, coaches, and staff, fans, and the university with class, dignity, and victory. Be safe and healthy this summer and do your part in stopping the spread of the virus, including social distancing and wearing your Gamecock-branded face coverings. So, hey, by the way, for those that are watching, my wife got me some of these cool bad boys for, it's my Alabama face covering for Father's Day. So I got that one, and then I got, yeah, there you go. So with that said, I found it a little odd that we are not going to know anything about this season or how anything's going to go until August. So we still got over a month before we figure out, okay, like what is happening, where are we going, what do we need to be prepared for, etc. Do you find this a little weird?
No, I don't find it weird, and I think it's, once again, it's wise. They are planning stuff right now, but to not come out with the plan publicly to anybody,
I think it's a smart idea. Yeah,
smart, because we don't know what anything's going to look like. And right now, we know all of these teams, especially the SEC, are going forward with football operations and practices. And if you get sick or you're traced to somebody who's sick, then you quarantine and we're moving this thing forward and we're progressing along. But, I think that this is a situation where we talked about this before. Why give the plan so early when you have no idea if it's even feasible or realistic at all?
We talked about it with California. Yeah.
Like they kept saying, we're not doing this until this and this. Why would you make that statement? Just what he said is exactly right. We're going to do what's best for our students and our fans and our school. And right now we don't know what that is. Now there's no doubt that they are having conversations about that, and they are putting plans in place about that.
By the way, let me interrupt you. Greg Sankey said on Feinbaum yesterday, they have between 15 and 20 different contingency plans.
Yes.
That is called wisdom.
That is smart. I appreciate leadership that looks for problems before they happen and tries to find solutions for, if this happens, how do we react? How do we respond? If this happens, how do we react? How do we respond? And you just move this ball forward.
And you don't get caught with your pants down. Because that's happened with a ton of guys in the past in this sport. So
athletic directors are the worst prepared people ever. We talk about this every year during coaching hiring season and firing season. When a coach leaves, and no one kind of expected that coach to leave for another job, these athletic directors act like they have never looked at a resume or done a search in their life. And it really bothers me that these athletic directors, who are highly compensated individuals, by the way, farm out the recruiting and sourcing of their coaching by hiring search firms. If you're a private school and you want to do that, you do whatever you want with your money. But when you're dealing with state tax dollars, no, sir. No, sir. You make seven figures for a reason, my friend. You get off your ass. You scroll through the agents. You give a bunch of people a call and see who's interested in your job and who's not.
The search firm thing is more so a networking resource, right? Because
that's fine. Screw that. Figure it out yourself.
I mean, you got a point. You got a point. Damian,
we pay you $1 million a year plus. Just about all these big Power Five athletic directors are making seven figures. Figure the damn thing out yourself. Or we're going to take the search firm hiring money out of your pocket. You write the check because we're already writing you a damn check.
You might have a point there. You might have a point there. Damian, who is coming in here trying to start fights with us today, said, I think college football season should be canceled and have the NFL do the games on Saturday like they planned. I don't know that they ever planned that, but why are you trying to take away college football, man? Like, what are you doing? Anthony Burke jumps in on YouTube, said there should be some kind of penalty if these schools don't pick up a replacement opponent just to not take it, take in.
I'm with you. If a replacement opponent is available and you just chose to not do it.
Yeah, you didn't take a risk.
Let's say you got Vanderbilt on the schedule and Vandy gets sick. And the only person available is Alabama or Georgia or Auburn. You're like, I think we're just going to sit this week out. No. You go pick up that fight, and you go fight that fight.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that's a smart idea. Like, hold it against them if they don't pick up a different opponent.
I absolutely would. I would call it an L. I really would. Be like, you had a chance to get a game in. You're just going to have an extra loss on the season.
Really, LSU and Florida from a few years ago when the hurricane hit Gainesville, or didn't even hit Gainesville, but they thought it might. That whole thing was weird. Now, they ended up playing that one.
That was Sankey. Sankey made that mistake. They played it at LSU, which counted as an LSU home game, and they gave LSU fans less than 36 hours notice that the game was going to be held at Tiger Stadium. Couldn't sell tickets, couldn't bring people in. So it counted as an LSU home game, and they barely had like 9,000 people there.
Yeah, it was.
That's bunk.
It was really weird.
Sankey being a Florida boy, and that was the first bad decision he made, and he's been pretty good ever since then.
He has been. He
still let his homer out.
It's what we talked about with getting caught with your pants down. They did not have a plan. They had no idea what to do. I think going forward, they've been better. So Matt Miller said, do you think indoor teams try to find outdoor stadiums? And we have more games start earlier since COVID dies pretty much immediately in sunlight. I'm not sure.
I don't know about that. Now, in college, we don't have a whole lot of indoor teams anyway.
No, there's really not. I'm trying to think. I mean, North Dakota State.
Syracuse. Syracuse still plays in the Carrier Dome.
Yeah.
There aren't many. And I'll tell you this. Yeah, if we found out that this thing really doesn't spread too badly outside, then I think I would probably say Syracuse, scour the area and find some small D3 school, especially if you're not going to have fans. It doesn't really matter where you play. Why play it indoors if you don't have to?
Yeah, no, agreed. Damian jumps back in. He's defending himself. He said, I have nothing against college football. I just don't think the students should risk playing college football if they are not getting paid. Look,
listen, nobody wants to fight for students like us. We agree on that.
Now, we do want to watch college football this season.
That's why I bring up money for all these other things is all don't throw away money. Yesterday we talked about how a couple million dollars is going to go to flying these people into Texas every day if we have a season. No, I'm not okay with that.
We're not down with that. Matt said the Idaho Vandals. Do you know they play inside?
No.
Now, I mean, they're FCS, so it wouldn't matter in D1, but
it's still I mean, everybody needs to find.
Yeah. I think a lot of
it, but yeah, if you think that indoor circulated air is what's causing a lot of problems, then yeah, I do think it would be smart to say everybody needs to just play outside.
Yeah. Matt jumps in and said people under 24 have a 0.03% death rate. The coaches and trainers are the biggest worry, not the players. Yeah. And that's why we're even talking about doing this, right? If it was a more significant threat as far as death goes,
you can't even talk about it then. Yeah.
Yeah. Matt said they're an FBS team. Yeah, they're an FBS team. No, they're an FCS team. Idaho is FCS. They dropped down 2 years ago. So, yeah, that's Idaho, I get you. But I don't remember them playing inside. That's strange. I'll have to go look that up. I don't know.